Welcome back, everybody. My name is Tim. This is another Real Ideal Gear Review. And today we're looking at the Mysterious Code Flieger Style Pilot Watch. And I smile when I say this because I'm not so sure this is a Flieger style watch. But that's what they call it. That's what they're advertising it as. So we'll go with what the title that they have. Wink, wink. I don't think this is a Flieger style. I think it's a pilot watch, but I don't know about the Flieger part of it. Great watch, though. A lot of great qualities to this watch. Miyota movement, titanium case, sapphire crystal. There's a lot of cool things about this watch. And for the price of $65-ish on AliExpress, find me a better deal than that when it comes down to a pilot watch. I just did a San Martin, the SN022, which has some similar qualities to it. Stainless steel case, stainless steel bracelet. But that one is much more expensive than this watch is. This has got a Miyota movement in here. So we're going to go through the five typical things that we go through, which are size, fitment, finish, accuracy, and legibility and lume, and see how this watch stacks up with other watches. All right, let's get into the size, fitment, finish, accuracy, legibility, and lume of the Mysterious Code Flieger watch. The size of this watch, as far as the case goes, 40 millimeters across as far as the diameter is concerned, 12.5 millimeters tall, and it has a 21 millimeter between the lug measurements. So it's got that weird lug measurement. The strap choices that are out there are going to be fewer because of that 21 millimeter. But I think there's a bunch of companies that are kind of picking up the slack here. So I don't think the 21 millimeter is kind of the black sheep that it's all made out to be overall. But the overall dimensions of this watch, I think, give a great proportions to this watch. I think it's better proportions than the San Martin SN022. Now, I love the San Martin SN22. I just think the proportions are a little bit too chunky because that's a 38 millimeter dial, so smaller than this one, and it's a 13 millimeter height off the wrist. So it's a smaller dial and it's even taller off the wrist than this one, which is a wider dial and it's a little bit closer to the wrist. So to me, the proportions, I love the proportions on this, which makes, I think, the fitment of this watch even better. When you have something that's a little bit closer to the wrist, I think it just feels and fits a little bit better overall. The strap on here is pretty good. It's, you know, it's an AliExpress strap. It says it's leather. Take their word for it. It takes a little bit of breaking in, and then actually it's pretty comfortable. Now, as far as the holes on here go, I think you can get the right fit for this watch. I think the holes are close enough together where you can fine-tune that fit. It is a little bit of a thicker strap, so it does take a little bit to get it into that first keeper, which is okay. I'd rather have it a little bit tighter than a little bit too loose, because if it's too loose, it just doesn't do a very good job of holding the strap, the loose part of the strap, or the tag end of the strap, for those of you into knot tying. The tag end is the part that sticks out. The keepers on this strap do a very good job. And now I've got the blue version, and the blue, I think, does a great job with the dial, but for some reason, I think I want to swap out the strap on this one. It's just a little bit too blue for me. I don't know if I should go gray, brown, tan, a light brown. So any suggestions you guys have as far as a color goes, I'm all ears for that. I just think it's a little bit too much blue for me, a little too much color all the way around. Although I do have other watches where they're like almost all orange. Maybe just get used to the color itself. So overall finish of this watch, I love the finish of this watch. It's a brush finish all the way around. There's nothing on here that has any flash of any significance whatsoever, which really makes this watch kind of a more of a tooly watch. You don't have to worry as much about the scratches or the fingerprinting. It has more of that utilitarian look, which is what this pilot watch is supposed to be. Now, the finishing of this watch, it's supposed to be a Flieger watch. And I just don't think it's a Flieger style watch when it comes down to what I've seen of other Fliegers that are out there. This to me is certainly a pilot watch because of the handset that's in there and the numbers are really clear and you have a really good minute track. The dial is a little bit bigger, although it's a 40 millimeter, it's not that much bigger, but you get the idea. Like it has kind of that pilot look to it, but I just don't know about the Flieger side of it. So I wouldn't go along with it being called a Flieger. I think this is an advertising tool to kind of get more people to look at it. People who are looking for Flieger watches is like, oh yeah, I recognize that one. It's not as Flieger-ish as most other Fliegers are. So to me, that's fine. It has a titanium case. This was something I totally missed when I ordered this watch. I did not know it had a titanium case. I love titanium. I think titanium is a great material. I love the color of titanium. It's not the bright, shiny stainless steel that I typically see. Titanium for me, I think, is one of my favorite materials for a case. the color, the durability, the lightweightness of it. It's a lightweight watch as a result of that as well. So the handset on here, I love the handset, sword handset. You've got that kind of faux patina lume that's on there. You've got the second hand, which is that same color on the side that you actually keep track of the seconds with, but it has that counterbalance on the backside that has this blue, very high polished look to it. And even the handset for the hours and the minute hands have a high polished blue outline to them as well that shine with you. You get the angle just right, you're going to get a blue reflection back, which is kind of cool, I think. It adds a little bit of flair to this watch that is pretty dull overall as far as not a lot of reflectivity in there at all. You've got a great minute tracker on the outside, which, by the way, that is lumed. The numbers are lumed. The handset is lumed. This watch has got a great lume pattern to it, and I'll show you the picture of the lume. Outstanding lume. Does this lume last all night? Yes, barely. Barely. So, in my opinion, this is great lume because at this price, $65, where are you going to get lume that lasts all night? Well, if you watched the previous videos on the Bernie watch, you would say the Bernie type B Flieger watch. So, and that was a $60 watch. That one is an amazing one too, as far as lume goes. So Mysterious Code has done a great job of getting great lume on there. It lasts almost all night. It lasts, I would say, 3/4 of the night, which is pretty outstanding for a $65 watch. Now, the accuracy in this watch, it has a Miyota 8215. It hacks, it hand winds. You've got a date movement in here, so you've got a date complication, which I think is great. I like the date. I'm warming up more and more to having or requiring a watch to have a date complication because I sometimes forget what the day is. So to me, that's a great complication to have. But overall, the accuracy, I don't have any issues with it. It's a Miyota movement, so I think the long-term longevity of it, servicing of it, reliability of it, I think this is all pluses for this watch. All right, water resistance, 50 meters of water resistance. It has the sapphire crystal. I don't think it has any AR coating on here. It does have quite a bit of reflection on there. If it is on there, it's not very good. But it's sapphire crystal, titanium case. I mean, this is lending itself to being a good work watch. Miyota movement, solid, reliable movement. 50 meters of water resistance, screw-down crown. Excellent handset, high contrast. I think the blue dial is dark enough to really offset the hour and minute hand and the second hand. The hour markers, the 1 through 12 hour markers, easily distinguishable from the dial itself. So a lot of great things about this watch. Titanium case, the lume is awesome. A lot of great things about it. What I don't like about it, no AR coating on a domed crystal. There's so many reflections that you get off this watch in the outdoors. It's tough. Tougher than it should be. It doesn't have to be that tough. Another ding too is just a 21 millimeter lug width. Like, why do that? Go 22 or go 21. Like, just going 21 to me, did I say 22? Like, the lug width of this watch, go 22 or go 20. Don't go 21. Like, stick to the ones that most people can deal with, and they don't have to go out and buy these odd numbered or oddly not as popular straps that are out there. And, you know, you have these, instead of just needing two sizes, maybe now you got to have three. So it's just one of those things, like, I think it's just unnecessary. What are the uses for this watch? Definitely a work watch. I think this is, you put a rubber strap on here and you've got a watch that will handle sweat, handles water, 50 meters of water resistance, screw down crown. But with that in mind, I think definitely a work watch, definitely one that you can handle in the office. It's got some classiness to it. Really easy to look at, the brushed finish. Definitely an office watch. Is it semi-formal in that category? Maybe. I think you could pull it off. I don't know about a blue strap like this. It's kind of a pretty colorful strap, but if you have like colorful attire on, you might be able to pull that off. As far as a formal watch, I don't think so. There's just no polish on here. It's a little bit too dull for that. It's not really that kind of dressy watch either, that formal dress watch. So I think the limit somewhere is going to be in that semi-formal range in there is going to be your limit as far as uses go. But as far as practical uses, I have no issues using this one for work. Manual labor type work, sapphire crystal, brushed case, titanium case, lightweight. This is a great watch. Overall score for this, 9.8 out of 10. Highly recommend this watch. I think it's a great buy. $65. For a watch with all of these characteristics on there, find me a pilot watch out there. I'm not going to call it a Flieger. Find me a pilot watch out there with a Miyota movement, titanium case, sapphire crystal, the lume that this has, quality leather, not the best, but it's quality leather, titanium pin buckle for $65. I just, like, that's an awesome deal. So highly recommend for me. Put in the comments down below what you think of this watch, of pilot watches in general. Anything about the Flieger style. And do you agree that this is a Flieger style watch or not? I'm curious to see what you have to say about that. So there you go. My name's Tim. This has been another Real Ideal Gear Review. We'll catch you guys next time.